Hi Aries, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a reading for you. This is for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. We're just going to see what comes up. This may or may not be for you. We're going to pull a couple Oracle cards at the end. We may use the stands or we may not. Whatever happens, happens. Let's see, what do we got for Aries? What do we have for Aries? This could be in the next couple of weeks, okay, or something that has already happened, or it's going to happen today, you know, whatever. Timing is fluid. What do we have for Aries? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. What do we got for Aries? Ooh, Six of Cups reversed. Now, this is clinging to the memories of the past. Not being able to let go of the memories, chained, stuck in the past. If you're stuck in the past, you got to try to do your damnedest to get out of it. Okay? You may have to leave it behind. If you think about the progression of this, the Six of Cups to the Seven of Cups to the Eight of Cups to the Nine of Cups. So if you are, you know, you're holding on to something in the past, you're only hindering your own wish fulfillment. You're only hindering, you know, having it all. You may have to, you know, make a decision, see things differently, and leave that emotional disappointment behind. It's like leaving that behind, okay? We got somebody here that is clinging to the memories of the past or clinging to the past, not able to completely move past it, right? Could be romanticizing about the past. You think about the next card, the Seven of Cups, you know, how it was, how it used to be, how it could be, okay? The Fool. Now it's time to really start with a clean slate. Leave it behind. Leave the past behind you. That is what these two cards say. Okay? Please leave the past behind you. Leave the past behind you. You can't take it with you into the future, Aries. When you start this new chapter, which you are in the beginning stages of, you cannot take it with you. You'll always have the memories. You'll be able to remember it. You'll be able to use it as experience. But it's time to start on a new journey with just take the experiences, okay, and the memories and let it go. All right. That is starting fresh, starting over. Now that when the Fool takes his journey, you know, when he starts over, he doesn't, you know, think about that little bag that he has. He only takes what he can fit in that bag, nothing else. All the rest of the baggage, nope. See ya. So, this is starting over, leaving everything else behind. The Hierophant. You gotta have faith. You gotta jump into this with blind faith. Have faith that there is a higher power. Have faith that this is for your highest good. Believe in the plan. Believe in the path. Believe in your journey. Believe that this happened for a reason. There's lack of faith here. Nine of Swords. This is worried. This is overwhelmed. Despair, anguish, sadness, feeling guilty, having regrets. This is too much. What's next? What's going to happen next? Right? What's going to happen next? You know, you're going to lose your concentration. You're going to lose your focus. You can't control things. Sometimes you just need to go with the flow. If it's time to let things go, it's time to let things go. Holding on to this past, whatever it is, it's just making you frustrated. It's affecting your equilibrium. It's affecting your health. It's affecting you in a negative way. It's not allowing you to concentrate and focus on bigger, better things. You guys are worried about things falling apart. Maybe you're worried about what everybody else has to say. Maybe you're worried about your status quo. I don't know. You are being called to take a leap of faith at this time. Step into your new life. Stop trying to control. Let go. Let go of the need to control. Just do it. Just do it. Have no fear. God is here. I'm sorry that slipped. It's true though. That didn't slip. Those words came out of my mouth. That didn't slip. Have faith, okay? Have faith in a higher power. Have faith. You don't have to have everything in under control. There's a higher power that has stuff under control. Believe it, please. Six of Pentacles reversed. Princess of Pentacles. Seven of Swords reversed. One-sided. Lack of reciprocation. Things are unbalanced. You have a new path opening up. A new opportunity to start fresh, to start over. But you have to take that step. It's like you're just deceiving yourself. The Seven of Swords next to you. Okay. Worried about getting caught or worried about something. You are worried, the Nine of Swords, you're worried about not being accepted. You will be accepted. Don't be worried about being accepted. You will be accepted. By whoever, that you have a new beginning here. Eight of Swords reverse. This is lying to yourself. This is an obstacle. Oh my goodness gracious. You guys have an obstacle in the way of your new life, of your new beginning. It has to do with the freaking past. The memories of the past. The past could have to do with children. Ace of Cups reversed, and the Three of Wands reversed. Oh, God. This is dashed expectations, delays. You're delaying love. You're delaying emotional fulfillment by staying trapped. Eight of Swords, that is a mental trap. But the Eight of Swords reversed is removing that obstacle, removing that mental barrier. That you don't deserve. That you don't deserve it. Or something like that. You do freaking deserve it. So if you think you don't deserve it, I'm here to tell you you do deserve it. Just in case you were thinking that, I'm here to clear that up. Okay? You got a new opportunity here with the Page of Pentacles. This is a new opportunity that could grow into something. But you're going to have to remain focused. You're going to have faith. Yeah, you're not going to know what's at the end of the road. You're not going to know what's out there. It's going to be unfamiliar to you. You will learn new things along the way. You'll become a different person. You won't be the same thing or the same person that you used to be. But this is something that can build your character. This is something that can bring you something more stable, bring you something more solid, bring you something more abundant. But you have to take that step, and you have to take that step in blind faith. Blind faith is where we're at. You can't lie to yourself. You can't deceive yourself. Don't be worried about getting hurt. Blind faith. Blind faith. Maybe the past hurt you so bad, I don't know, that you are so afraid. This is fear. My advice is to take a risk. This is in your challenge position, giving to a situation, giving somebody a chance, you know, unprotecting yourself, stepping outside of your comfort zone. You know, that's your challenge. You have a new beginning here to leave everything behind. Leave all the baggage behind. The biggest thing that you have to leave behind is the past. I read a quote the other day and it's like the past. I can't remember it. All we have is the now. Right? Focus on right now. Don't focus on the future. Don't focus on the past. Right now, you have an opportunity to step into a new life. To step outside of your comfort zone. You have an opportunity to go someplace else. But fear and lack of faith is hindering you. Find your moral backbone to go down that path that you have never traveled. Because that is what you are meant to do at this time. Without a plan. You don't need to have everything in order. Just do it. Just do it. Let's get a couple of these. Worried about getting cheated, worried about getting hurt, worried about what could happen. Have faith. It's not going to be easy to do something that you've never done before. It's not going to be pretty. It's definitely not going to be easy, okay? There may be roadblocks along the way. Those are just obstacles that help you to grow, okay? They give you life experience. They make you into the emperor. If you're always controlling things, you can't learn new things. Not really. If it always has to be, you know, just exactly this way, whatever. No. To learn new things, you got to step outside of your comfort zone. And that is what this is about. What do we got for Aries? One card. We're going to get another one too. Oh, there it is. Oh, there it is. Woo! Past life relationship. You have known each other before. So you have a new beginning here with somebody you have known before. It's not this person in the past. See? This is in the future. This is in the future. The past is the past. In the future. In the future, after you take that leap, you take that leap, you take that step, you leave the past behind, you meet somebody that you have known before. What do we got here for Aries? What do we got? Medicine. I'm going to read that. Found an employment, social circles, families, organizations, spiritual groups, leaders, nurture, guide, and support us through life at all levels in all situations. People seek out leaders for survival, purpose, and achievement. The ability to heal and work with different energies and the gift of vision are the medicine of the shaman, bridging the world of earth, nature, self, and spirit. Looking to a leader or elder for guidance and mentorship is essential now. Remember, true leaders empower, direct, and facilitate transformation. A false leader, however, can tear down progress, destabilize social networks, and create spiritual cults. Powerful healing energy is around you right now. You are strongly connected to shaman medicine. Okay. Journey within the realms to learn and share in the messages from your ancestors. Past life journeys can reawaken your soul's natural gifts and assess your ancestral power to enlighten and illuminate your direction. Right now, you need to harness the power of natural remedies, herbal medicines, and natural skincare products. Visit a professional to assist you to support your mind, body, and spirit. Use complementary medicine in addition to traditional healing methods. You are a natural healer. You are being asked to utilize your natural talents in the healing arts. Whether for counseling, energy practice, holistic, or Western medicine, you are encouraged now to explore your gifts with purpose. Take a leadership role. You have the knowledge and guidance to heal yourself as well as others. Lead by example. Be humble and graceful in your approach. Affirmation. I am a powerful healer. The power of the universe shines within me. I am a powerful light bringer. You are. So anyway, Aries, you do have a new beginning here. But it's not in your past. Good luck.